We are blessed once again to stand before you, to give you just a few more tools that you can use in this life that will help your life get better. Amen. And I pray to God that what is being said today, that you will take it and use it in your everyday life. I have just one scripture. If you can stand for the reading of the Word of God, Philippians 2 and 2. Amen. Philippians 2 and 2. Amen. If you're there, say amen. If not, say wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
Amen. Together we stand and divided we fall. Amen. The Word of God says this, when we touch and agree as one, being on one accord, he said he would be in the midst. And I believe that. Amen. Philippians chapter 2, verse 2. And the Word of the Lord reads, make my joy complete by being of the same mind. Maintain the same love, united in spirit, intent on one purpose. I pray that the Lord will add a blessing to the readers, the hearers, and most of all, the doers of his holy word. Amen?
Amen.
You might be seated. If you would allow me to put a title to this message today, it simply says, same mind, same love, same spirit equals unity in the body. Amen? Come on, can you say that with me? Same mind,
same love,
same spirit equals
unity in the body.
Amen. This is a now season word. I've learned that if the church cannot come together in unity, how can we expect the world to come together in unity? We set the example, amen? Before the world, we have to be on one accord. We have to do it right so the world can see exactly how God wants it to be done. Christ's vision for the church, his body, the church, has always been one of a loving, compassionate family. Amen. His dream is that we would be so connected to each other in our hearts, that is, if one member suffers, guess what? All members suffers with the same thing. Or if one member is honored, all members rejoice with him. 1 Corinthians 12 and 26, however, teaches us truth. Behold, not everyone is as lovable as we would desire them to be. And not everyone is skilled as resolving conflict. Therefore, it is common to find tension and strained relationships within the confines of the church. Amen?
Okay.
Can we agree to disagree?
Okay.
Amen. It's here, right here in the church. Amen. But nevertheless, Paul exhorts, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. That's Philippians 2 and 5. It is imperative that as Christians that our minds are under the authority of Christ and Christ alone. We try to do it on our own because we think we know it all. But our minds should be under the authority of Christ and Christ alone. There is a spirit of apostasy that is causing so much division and disunity among the people of God in this day and time. Now, when we look at the word apostasy, I went to the dictionary and I looked it up. Webster says it's the act of leaving behind or straying from your religious or political beliefs or your principles. Amen? We're talking about apostasy in the church. Let's look at one of the signs of apostasy in the Christian church today, which is falling from the truth. Amen?
Yeah.
It is the bickering, It is the disunity among Christians that brings out this spirit of apostasy. How can we be witnesses to the world about the love of Christ, about the power of Christ, about the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, with the spirit of apostasy dwelling among us? I hear the world saying, why should I go to church? The church people are acting like the world. This is a disgrace in the eyesight of God. We set the example. Amen. John 13 and 35, Jesus said that the world would know that we were his disciples by what? By the love that we have for one another. Amen. In the words of the late Donny Hathaway, if any of you know him, he has a song that simply says, where is the love? Amen. Hallelujah. People of God, and in Corinthians 3 and 14, it says that love is the perfect bond of unity. Amen. If nothing else, the love of God should unify us together as one. Amen. Ephesians 4 and 5 in the New Testament, it speaks about us being unified in Christ. One Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Amen. What is it that unifies us, that brings us together? Primarily, it is the saving work of Christ that unites us together as one. We have as a common heritage the blood of Christ that has been shed for the forgiveness of sin. True Christians serve the true and living God, and we know Jesus in a personal and an intimate way. 1 Corinthians 1 and 9, God is faithful, amen, who has called you into fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. We have been redeemed by God himself, amen. Furthermore, we have the body of scriptures which tells us the essence of the faith, and deviating from these essence means to be outside the camp of Christ, amen. It is the essential doctrines that we must know and unite in. As I say so many times, it is the word of God that is going to get us from earth to glory. Amen. So why not allow the word of God to get us together while we're down here and keep us together until the Lord returns? The Christian church as a whole needs to, guess what? Needs to repent. Amen. We need to look at ourselves. We need to look at our churches. We need to look at one another and decide that we will stand on the essential documents of the faith and that we will be united against the enemy. Amen. And we all know who the enemy is. Those of us who are united by the blood of Christ are not enemies with one another. Amen. Can I say that again? Those of us who are united by the blood of Christ are not enemies with one another. Amen. Therefore, we need to seek to work together to further the kingdom of God. Amen. Apostasy begins in our hearts. Amen. When we put distance between ourselves and our brothers and our sisters in Christ because of, guess what? Different opinions. Amen. Simply as that. Let's not commit apostasies in our hearts by abandoning the truth of God's call of unity and love within, hallelujah, within the body of Christ. Amen. For it is the devil that wants us to fight each other. Amen. So that he can free us up to deceive the world. Amen. If we are fighting each other, then we are falling prey to, guess what? His tactics. Amen. And God forbid we are caught off guard to allow the devil to deceive the people of God. I know that it is easy to speak these words and it is very difficult to apply them. That is true, because true love is difficult to really love. Amen. But what if the world began to see the Christian church uniting, hallelujah, in spite of its differences? What if the world starts to see how the Christian church starts to love, amen, not only their own church members, but other church members, amen? We are people that we don't care nothing about nobody else's church, because guess what? They're not the same denomination that we are. They are Church of God in Christ, and we are Baptists. Or they are apostolic, and we are Methodists. God's word said that we should love everyone, amen? What do you think the world would say if the churches stopped bickering? Amen. It's going on, amen. It's going on. What do you think the unbelievers would say if they saw us living more and more the loving attitude and the sacrificial life of Christ across denominational barriers? Amen. It would be a tremendous witness for Christ. Yes, it would. It would be a tremendous assault on the enemy. Amen. And I know that God would use it to magnify, to bring others to himself by his grace. The hearts and the minds are so closely related that we must guard them both. Amen. The heart and the mind are so closely related that we must guard them most. We must focus on the truth of God's word and let our minds be shaped by it. Amen. We must seek to have our minds shaped by the love of God as we move not only to hear about him, but also to carry out his desires. Amen. What should we do to bring unity wherever possible or whenever it's possible? We need to look at our own hearts, first of all, and our own minds, and compare them to Jesus and the scripture. Amen. Does our hearts and our minds line up with the word of God? Whenever the two are not in agreement, amen, it is then that who needs to change? Amen. We need to pray that the Lord will provide us opportunities to work with other Christians. Amen. We need to recognize that we have differences of opinions. Amen. And that's okay. But we need to lift others up and be united in Christ. Amen. The Apostle Paul wrote in 1 Corinthians 15 verses 1 through 4. He's, now I declare to you, brethren, the gospel which I preach to you, which also you receive, in which also you stand, by which also you are saved. Hold firmly the word which I preach to you, unless your belief is in vain. For I delivered to you, first of all, that which I have received, that Christ died for our sins, according to the scriptures, that he was buried, and he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures. It is through believing the facts in these statements of the scripture and in the love of God shown and commanded by our Lord Jesus Christ and exercised in our love for each other that we are empowered by the Holy Spirit. Amen. As Christians, to have unity of the Spirit, we can obtain to the unity of the faith. It is God's purpose. It is God's purpose that all believers to obtain the unity of the faith. Amen. Those who are mature in Christ are those who are reaching unity in faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God. Those who are not matured, hallelujah, strive for interfaith unity, thinking that they are growing in the Lord. Amen. And it is usually a point of pride for them. Amen. But they have mistaken what Paul was talking about. Unity in the faith is talking about coming to a common understanding and practice of the core of truths of the faith as taught to us in the Bible through Jesus Christ, amen, and the apostles. We already have the unity of the Spirit, and we believe and as born again of the Holy Spirit. We look at Romans 6 and 5. If we have been been united with him like this in his death, we will certainly also be united with him in his resurrection. Amen. If, it simply says that if we are united with Christ in his death and resurrections, we are also united together as the body of Christ. Amen. 1 Corinthians 12 and 27, it says, now you are the body of Christ. Amen. And each of you are a part of it. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, you are a part of the body of Christ. How many of you believe that? Hallelujah. It is true that we must also make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through peace among the brethren. Amen. Ephesians 4 and 3, it simply teaches us to make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. Amen. But there is also a unity of faith, amen, that we as Christians must strive for in order for us to be in the faith and not in heresy, which is any belief or practice that goes against the official position of the church. If we wander away from the truth, we wander away from the unity of the faith, amen. I'm talking about togetherness here and what Pastor preaches to us every Sunday. Amen. When I've heard people to go against what she's preaching, then that's not right. Amen. There are many types of wandering. Amen. Example in the Bible. It's explained in the Bible. The one, there is a wandering from the faith through greed. Amen. If you look at 1 Timothy 6 and 10, it simply tells us, for the love of money is a root of all kind of evils. Some people are eager for money. Then they've wandered away from the church. They've wandered away from the faith. They have pierced themselves with many griefs. Amen. There is also a wandering from the faith by believing in false teaching. Amen. Yeah. There was a thing when my pastor back home used to always say, you can't eat at everybody's table.
That's right.
And simply saying that you can't get what God has for you here and then go somewhere and hear, listen to what somebody else is saying that is contrary to what is being taught here. Amen. There is also wandering from the faith by believing in false teaching. In 2 Timothy 2, 17 and 18, it says, their teaching will spread like gangrene. Amen. Among them are Hymenaeus and Philetus, who have wandered away from the truth. They say that the resurrection has already taken place. Amen. And they destroy the faith of some. Amen. You just can't believe everything you hear. Amen. First Timothy 6, verses 20 to 21, Timothy guards. Timothy tells us to guard what has been entrusted in our care. Amen. Simply saying that what God has put into your heart through the word, you have to guard it. Amen. Turn away from godless chatter. I'm stepping on somebody's toes. Hallelujah. I'm simply saying, turn away from gossip. Amen.
Yes.
And the opposing ideal of what is falsely called knowledge. Amen. We talked about that earlier in Sunday school. Allowing knowledge to take us to a place where God has not called us to go. Amen. Which some have professed and in so doing have wandered away from the faith. Amen. Those who are entrusted with overseeing the church of Jesus Christ has a given responsibility, amen, to bring the flock into a unity with the core documents of the faith. It's talking about those that stand before you that preaches the word of God. We have a responsibility, amen. We have been entrusted. God has entrusted you into our hands, oh God, to teach you what thus saith the Lord. If we are not doing that, but instead bringing wings of doctrine to bring on our own flocks, the Bible says this will cause disunity in the faith. Amen. We are to reject men who are disunity for of the faith, because in these people they are lifted to operate free. They are left, if they are left operated to operate freely in the body of Christ, it can cause the faith of men to be shipwrecked and destroyed. Amen. This is what we are seeing happening today on Christian TV and in Christian, in churches worldwide. There is also a result of Christians either not understanding the concept of unity of faith or just simply ignoring it. True unity of the faith can only be put into the practice by understanding what the Bible is teaching. Amen? Its content and living it out in our lives. Amen. Yet for some Christians today, the word doctrine is immediately pushed to the sidelines in favor of experience. Amen. You got so many people that want to tell you about what they've been through, and it's good. Amen. How the Lord brought them out, it's good. It's all good. But if you don't have the word of God to stand on, you cannot live on nobody else's testimony. Amen. You have to let, you have to live and stand on the word of God. Amen. It is immediately pushed to the side in favor of experience. One wise man says that if your doctrine is not correct, then your experience will not be correct either. Amen. What Paul was teaching was that the Ephesians was that the doctrine is the most important thing in our lives. Amen. Come on, turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, doctrine is important in our lives. Hallelujah. What you believe is the most important thing about you. Amen. Because if you believe in the wrong things, your believing is in vain. Amen. Countless numbers of people who call themselves Christians today are believing, guess what, in another Jesus. Amen. They're believing in a different spirit. They are believing in a different gospel. So it matters what you believe. Amen. When true believers come together into the unity of the Spirit, they will also be working toward the unity of faith. Anything that distracts from the pursuit of unity of the faith is not a good thing. Amen. This is one tool you can use to test any church, to test any organization or any individual who claims to be following the Lord. Are they bringing Christians to the unity of faith, or are their doctrine causing division? Amen. You can see it. Test it. Amen. As I take my seat, amen, as a prisoner of the Lord, I urge you to live a life worthy of calling that you have received. Amen. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient. Amen. Bringing with you one another and bearing with one another in love. Okay. Make every effort to bring the unity of spirit through the bonds of peace. Amen. Therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort for love, if any common sharing in the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make his joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, having being in one spirit and of one mind. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit, rather in humility value others above yourself. Amen. Philippians 2, 1 and 3. Somebody ought to give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. For the word of God. Y'all know me, it don't take long to bring the word of God. Amen. I pray that someone will have been blessed by this word on today. Unity. Amen. Coming together in unity in spirit. Amen. Coming together in unity in the faith. Amen. That's what makes us stronger. Amen. The old saying says, together what we stand, and divided we do what? We fall. When you listen to false teaching, that divides us. Amen. When you stand on what you think is right, that makes us fall. Amen. But if we stand together in the truth, in God's truth, God will bless us. Amen. And he will take us to heights unknown. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Come on, stand on your feet. Stand on your feet.